All right. This game is called The Renovator Origins. Now, this is a demo. I'm assuming there's a renovator, not Origins. Like maybe there was like another game and then this is the sequel. But I didn't play the original one, so hopefully we don't need to know anything about The Renovator before we play The Renovator Origins. And this is also a demo. So maybe if I like this, we'll go back and check out The Renovator, assuming there is a Renovator non-Origins. But yeah, so this is a this is just a demo. Don't expect to be too long, but I mean, the graphics looked really good in the screenshots that I saw. This thing looks creepy. I don't know what this is. It's kind of like Christmas doll. But yeah, how was Outlast? It was really good. Really good. I mean, frustrating as fuck. Absolutely frustrating. Rockstar said that they were going to stop working on small projects and stick to their own games. Yeah, that's what I assume that they would do. Go back and forth every year. 1 year do Red Dead, another year, or not year, but you know, Red Dead releases, a couple years later GTA, then Red Dead, then GTA, because those are the cash cows. They didn't make a lot of money with Red Dead Online, but they still sold like a shit ton of copies of the, you know, for story mode. But yet, so what I'm saying is that, is this the second game in the series? The Renovator Origins would technically be a prequel if there is a Renovator, because this is going to tell you the origins of the Renovator. So you know what? Good news, we probably didn't have to play the original one because this is going to explain how it all started. So this is probably a prequel. But regardless, I'm assuming it's the second game in the series of The Renovator.
The Renovator. Renovator versus Terminator.
Okay, you guys ready for this? Enough talking. Enough talking. All right, you guys ready? You guys ready, guys? Here we go. All right, new game. Wait, is there a... No, it's, the FPS is locked at 60. I don't see anything to kick that up. All right, The Renovator Origins. The game was created by Rynat. Come on, man! You can't throw a name like that at me and then expect me to read the whole fucking paragraph in like 2 seconds. If his name was John Smith, I still would have struggled. Where am I? I think I recognize this place. It seems to be the apartment where my father grew up. But how did I get here? I was gonna turn the audio up, the dialogue. Oh, what the? Okay. You know what? I'm not even gonna read that. We'll figure it out. I don't need a map. Famous last words. Okay, now we're lost. Alright, let me just turn the volume up. Just a tad. I just want to turn the effects up a little bit. Right, let's try that. It sounds very quiet. And I have my audio up the whole way. No flashlight.
Не поддается.
Won't budge. Alright, is there a light switch? Looking for a light switch. I do hear music. What's this? Another door. Dude, it's so dark, man. We gotta find a... Nah, there's no way that they're gonna expect us to be in here without some sort of... What's this? There we go. Not your common light switches. Oh, okay, good. I thought they were like outlets that were really high up on the wall. I thought they were like USB plugs that were just really, really high up there. How is the audio? Can you guys hear like how is that? It's perfect? Okay, maybe I'll turn my headphones up a little bit. Okay. Alright. Again, I'm not too sure what the objective is. Okay, to use the lamp, you need kerosene. The kerosene in your inventory will gradually decrease when the lamp is in use. To put away or take out the lamp, press T. T for take. T for take out the lamp. Game looks good. I thought I... The lights flickered over here. And I thought I saw something out of the corner of my eye. Like a figure standing right there briefly. But I think I'm just seeing things. All right, my father was a bit of a chess player. I hated my father. My father liked to play chess, but I always beat him as a child. Oh, like in chess? No, I just beat the shit out of him. I didn't like him. He was an alcoholic. He attacked me. I beat the shit out of him. But I always beat him as a child. He looked calm, but I could see the anger in his eyes on account of the drinking. Okay, T for take. Wait, what? Okay, we need kerosene. I tried to pull out the lamp, but I guess we can't use it until we get kerosene. Okay, I will help you, son. Find the family ring. Okay, I definitely heard footsteps. Dude, maybe I did see something. What? Was that me? Dude, I keep hearing doors opening and shutting. I don't know if it's me or if it's... Oh, no. Alright, I don't want to go in here yet. Wait. Yes, I do. Come on! Open the goddamn door!
Черт. Надо заменить лампочку, иначе в темноте я
ничего... Need to change the light bulb, otherwise I'm gonna find anything in the dark. Okay, what's this? Oh, look, we get this little light right here, we're fine.
Нечем поджечь.
We gotta find a lighter, because there are a bunch of candles around. Rain looks good. I was thinking if I turned around and there was a silhouette standing in the doorway, I was going to freak out. That's what I was anticipating. All right, we got to find a ring. We got to find a light bulb. I don't know if we can find that in here. We need a key for this door. I don't know what the hell this is. This is the thing in the menu screen. It's the same toy from my father's childhood. It only looks new now, still no less creepy. It only looks new now. Still. It jingles. What does this mean? Danger Quad, thank you for the one bit. Get yourself something nice. You know, like, you know how people flick a penny? Like really fast, they like flick it and they shoot it across the room. Whenever I get one bit, that's what I picture. Someone just going, "Hey, Swol," and that like hits me in the temple. Get yourself something nice. Don't spend it all in one place. Oh, two bits. Akimbo bitties. All right, we can't open that yet, right? It still won't budge. All right. Is there a light bulb in here? I got a bird cage. Wait, what did it say? A bird cage with some sort of strange mechanism. I wonder how it works. I was expecting him to be like, my father had a pet bird. Like, everything he says is about his father. Okay, looking for a copy of Death Chord 3. Okay, no Death Chord 3. Oh, here's our fuel. Wait, take it. No light bulbs in here. T for take. Take lamp. Badge with the slogan, proletarians of all countries unite. One of the most famous communist slogans. Is that it? Can we take this money? What's this? VLKSM is a public organization that unites Soviet youth.
We are in Mother Russia.
All right. According to the label, it's drawing charcoal. There were no markers back then. Can we just get like, is this matches? I'm looking for a pack of matches. Here we go. There we go. Now we can light the candles. All right, making progress. What is this? According to the label, it's a box. Wait, this is a box from the Sputnik brand razor. It was my father's. My father used to shave his face with Sputnik brand razors. Can we pick that up? Okay, no light bulbs, but we do have matches so we can light the... I didn't even check in here yet. Okay, good. Still no Death Chord 3. A little disappointed. Actually, I get pretty excited when I don't see Death Chord. But I'm going to change my Discord server to Death Chord. Death Chord 3 is going to be the name of my Discord server from now on. But yeah, anytime you see Death Chord 3, it usually means that the developer used a template, like a copy and paste template from like the Unity engine, I think is where they get it from. Which isn't bad. Where is this blood coming from? I told you there's someone roaming around these hallways. Now he's leaking everywhere. Can I light this now? Yeah. And light this one here. Yeah. Alright, looking for a light bulb. Can't see anything in there. No one out on the street. Oh, we're in the kitchen, okay. A pack of milk? This is... Could you imagine drinking this? Where do you open? Like, where do you start? Just bite a corner?
Just bite a corner and suck it down.
What was that thing in the office? The pyramid? The saber pyramid?
From the makers of the saber pyramid comes triangle milk.
Oh, whoa. Good old stew. Father always said they used to make it from real beef.
A miracle.
I'm waiting. I'm waiting to turn around and there'll be someone standing there. It's gotta happen. I still feel like I saw somebody in the beginning. I'll have to check the tape. Discord 3. Evil Dragon, thank you for the 16-month resub. Appreciate that. Speaking of, there's the Discord server.
Boo.
P. Flaharts, welcome back. These games are just getting better and better. I guess so. River Bottom, thank you for the 23-month resub. Baby Cakes, thank you for the 6 biddies. Much love. Appreciate that, man. All the way from Emmett Otter's Jug Band Christmas and into our Twitch chat. Appreciate it. Jam a straw in there. Oh, yeah. Jam a straw into the pyramid of milk. What's up, Marsh? Graphically, Swole, but horror games still have a hard time finding a great... I know, and someone even commented on one of my YouTube videos about how... It was Rewind or Die. They said it was the first horror game in a long time that actually had a decent ending. It's true. Although, Suffer the Night... I don't know, man. I have such mixed feelings on Suffer the Night because of... The beginning was so good. All the stuff in the house. You go to the attic at the end. He attacks you and then kidnaps you anyway. The game could have ended right there. But then they pick up where you're like in this castle. And then you end up in a funhouse. Then you end up at a rave or something. Like looking for invisible people through it with a flashlight. Or like a camera light attachment. And then you have to... You have to fight the guy in the top hat in a boss fight. It got really weird, but at least it had an ending. Yeah, the night was just too long to suffer. Yeah, I'll keep playing after I finish the demo, but I do want to start streaming earlier tomorrow. I want to do what's called a stream week. I had this idea where I don't want to edit this week at all on YouTube. I just want to, you know. If we get some good footage and I send it to Zafiri and he edits a video for me, cool, I'll upload it. But I want to put all my focus in Twitch this week and just stream Zelda, enjoy it, you know, not... Like, when I play games like this, I stop playing, I talk to you guys, and then I go back to the game so that when I upload this to YouTube, it makes it easier to edit out the Twitch chat and, like, make it an actual video. But with Zelda, I have no intention of like making that into a video because it's going to be way too long to even like I wouldn't even know where to begin with that. Like, how do I condense this to a video? So with the bigger games like that, I just talk the whole time and I don't even worry about it. So I can't wait to just get back to like streaming normal, you know. The different language, I think they're speaking Russian. Yeah, I got a Switch. Yeah, I got the Zelda Edition Switch. I also ordered... I got this little thing that connects to the Switch that lets you use your Xbox controller. The fuck is that? Game's getting impatient. I tried my Xbox controller. And I tried my PS5 controller, and both are listed as being compatible with it. Neither one works. Watch 3 tutorials, nothing. They're like, yep, all you do is press the button here, hold this button down your controller, and you're good to go. And like, I'm watching the video, and it's like, bling, and it's like connected. I'm like, meanwhile, I'm like sitting here for like 20 minutes, just like holding buttons down and nothing happening. What's the cord name? It's actually, it's a wireless thing. I thought it was, I want one that I can plug in. Because if I'm going to be streaming, I don't want my controller dying and then being like, okay, I don't know what to do now. But when I ordered it, I thought it had like a, you know, a place where you could plug in the controller as well. It didn't. And it was a 8-bit do or the bit do to something. I ordered a pro controller. It's not the Nintendo one, but it's for the Switch. It was like $20. So that'll be here tomorrow. I don't think it'll be here in time for me to, because I want to stream earlier in the day. If it's not here in time, I'm just going to use the Joy-Cons with the little controller thing, and then I'll have it ready for Tuesday. Okay. I do see that there's blood coming out from the door. We still don't have a key, though, so we gotta search for a key. Let me pull up the lamp here. All right, we got a cupboard right here. Oh, we got fuel for our lamp. Nope, take it. Take it. Nothing here. Here's a drawer. No key. What is this? My father used to open cans. Have I ever told you about my father? Yes! Yes, you did. He used to keep keys in the freezer. Wait, I hear voices outside. Wait, to get a better look at an object or see what is in the distance, press the right mouse button. Oh! There is somebody outside. What? I just heard yelling. I didn't think we could actually see somebody. I thought it was just like ambient noises. What's this? Oh, wait. My father liked to store things in small containers. Apparently, it was passed down to him from his father. E to open. I bet there's a key inside. Wait. We can't open it? E to open? I mean, I see this. Do we need a small key for that? March 12th, 1957, in case you guys are wondering. Okay, so no key in here? No Kia? Wonder who that guy was running down the street. Alright. It looks like we need something to open up this box. S to smash box on ground. Oh shit. Is that the doorbell or is that the phone? What was that? It sounded like a blanket. Hold on. Is there a...
Не поддается.
Won't budge. All right. And there's no peephole. It sounded like a blanket shifting. Like someone was making a bed. No. Turn that on. Part of the diary that my father's kept since childhood. March 4th, 1957. My father says that I have a vivid imagination, but I know for sure that I didn't make it up. It all started after my parents arrived back from Romania. Sometimes passing by the mirror, my reflection seems to behave strangely. It looks as though it's moving slower than me, and its gaze is always in my direction. Every time I look in the mirror, it's like it's looking back at me. Like, no matter where I look at it, it's always staring back at me. What is going on? But as soon as I turn on the light, the reflection becomes normal again. So this is happening in the dark? Still looking for a key. So now we gotta look for a reflection. Oh! He was watching us. Dude was watching us. Can I jump on the bed? Is there anything? Oh, dude, we actually have legs and shoes and a shirt. That's nice. That's a step up. Lately, we've had nothing. We've just been a floating camera. Dude, okay, I'm not seeing a... Won't budge. Wait, did that just open? It's open. Oh, fantastic. Hey, aren't you gonna come in here? Alright, is there... What is this? Mechanical razor with winding, more brutal shave than an axe. Mechanical razor with winding, more brutal shave with an axe. What is that? More brutal shave with an axe? I don't know what they're trying to say. More brutal than an axe? Is there somebody in the corner? No. No one behind the door? Anybody in the bathtub? Is a hand gonna reach out and grab me? No. Okay, good. Wait. Oh no! No!
Oh, shit.
Damn, it looks like the electrical panel in the entranceway, something. My father was an electrician. Alright, what's this? Is that a key? It's a key, but it looks like it's in a piece of petrified shit. All right, how do we get this out? How did it get in there in the first place? Oh, old key in clay. Maybe I can clean it with water. All right, well, it's much easier than I thought it was going to be. He's still out there. What's he pointing at? He's pointing at something. What's he pointing at? Maybe we have to look through a... Are those eyes? Oh! Oh my god. Okay, they're not eyes. They're just the outlets. And I saw that thing peek out the first time. I thought I was looking at this and like a ghost or some shit, like just looked out from around the corner and then I realized it was the doll. All right. Well, it still doesn't. There's still something lurking around here. Oh fuck! What the fuck? See to crouch. Find a happy place. I don't know what the hell that guy was pointing at. All right, we gotta clean this key off. Can I turn the lights back on? No. Okay, all the electrics off. Perfect. Just how I like it. All right, well, the toy and the... whatever it is. It had like a hook. It looked like it had like a little hook for a hand when it turned off the lights. All right, here we go. Can we turn on the sink? All right. Use. Here we go. Okay, we have a key. The question is it for the door? Or is it for the box? Maybe there's another key. Here, yeah, it's for the box. Okay. I don't know what we just took. My father liked to store things in small containers. Yep, okay. Is that it? Can we grab that? What's that? There's like a bracelet or something in there. Can we grab that? Shake it out. Shake it. Fuck. Am I gonna leave the water on? Yeah, they call me the wet bandit. Spoiler alert, I don't live here. Your water bill is gonna be high. I don't live here. Call Kevin McAllister. Not my problem. I'm scared, bitch. The guy was pointing at the letters in the road. Ooh, okay. Marie, how are you doing? Sammy Marie. My father was a bit of a plumber. Okay, I don't know what this is. A jar. A porcelain jar. All grandmothers should have a porcelain collection. What's in the jar? I thought the game was paused, but apparently it's not. Alright. I guess we'll turn off the water. Conserve water, save on the, I was gonna say save on the electric bill. Save on the water bill. Alright, the guy is not out in the street anymore. Not over here, at least. Let's turn these back on. Oh, we're out of candle. We're out of matches. Okay, so we found one key. Great. It looked like a kid. Okay, it looks like the electrical panel turned on by itself. Oh, good. Wait, and it looks like the ghost is typing to us. All right, the ring is inside, son. The ring is inside, son. Like, is it inside me? It was inside you all along. The ring is inside. Inside the doll? Maybe we have to, Oh, wait. What about this? Can we break this? No. All right. I wonder if it's inside that doll we have to... Do we check these? Scissors. Yeah, I'm going to take these. I don't know if we can use this as a weapon. More match... No. Yeah, more matches. I think that's what that was. I didn't look. Okay, we have another letter here. February 24th, 1957. Hooray, my parents returned from Romania. I felt uncomfortable in their absence. I'm scared when I'm alone in the apartment, even during the day. I no longer want them to leave for a long time. My parents brought me a bunch of gifts and souvenirs, but importantly, they bought antiques from an auction, but I was forbade from touching them by my father. They locked everything in the pantry. I didn't even have time to look at them. All right, so the pantry is probably what we're trying to get into. All right, and the power's back on, so we can turn. The key is inside. Well, let's go out here in the hallway. Turn our lamp on, get some lights back on here. There we go. All right. How about right here? All right. Let me see. Okay. The guy is gone. Oh. It says behind what? Is there another word? Wait. Let me go check out the other windows. It just says behind. Behind a photo. Wait, is there a window here? No. Okay. Behind. I have no idea what he's talking about. I don't know where the doll went. Okay, those aren't doors. We still have any lights in the kitchen, though. Got a light in the hallway. Behind. No words out there. Wait, are those matches too? Yeah. The key is inside. The key is inside the entire time. Use? Nowhere to apply. Okay. Wait. Is there anything we can cut? We have these scissors. The key is inside. We cut the sofa. Nowhere to apply. We cut the pillows. Nowhere to apply. Let me put that away before we waste all of our juice. Oh, what's this? Nothing. Okay. Wait, is there other things I can turn around? Behind the mirror? Alright. Cyborg, thank you for the prime sub. Soul is the best. Appreciate all those biddies. Thank you so much. Baby Cakes, thank you for the 12 bits. It was like a bracelet, but it won't let me pick anything up. Oh, okay. So behind was just letting me know to turn around for the jump scare. Okay. And we can't open that. I'm about to be out of lighter fluid. Wait, was this chair always knocked out? Yeah. The kid knocked that down when he ran away. Let me, it's like some of the electricity works, but not all of it. Previously, all the equipment was from our production, not like now. Okay. Can we open this? Yeah, like, look, there's like a little latch. Can we open that? No. Sassy Cat, thank you for the raid. Appreciate that. Yeah, you know what? We should check out that porcelain. Game is okay. Just a little stuck right now. No big deal. It can't be too complicated. What's this? That's just a clock. All right. Let me check out this porcelain thing. Can we inspect this at all? Drop. Oh, I thought it meant like just drop the inventory. Oh, okay. Here's the ring. Ooh, it's a mood ring. An old family ring that belonged to my grandfather. Okay. In a difficult moment, the ring will help you find the way. It'll start to glow when the desired item is nearby. To remove the ring, press T. So, what about the lantern? Do I have to equip it? Use. Okay, we're actually holding it. Okay, I see it now. All right. Looking for a key to the door? The ring is not glowing. My secret decoder ring is not glowing. Nothing there. When it said drop, I thought it meant like drop an item. You know, like just drop it out of your inventory. I didn't know they actually meant drop it on the floor to break it. Ring is not glowing. I'm guessing that it's behind a photo. How close do we have to be for it to actually react? Wait, anything behind this blanket over here? No. Come on now. Oh, wait. Wait. Scissors? Use? Nothing nearby. Where did he... Oh! Okay, it's not in the bathroom. I thought maybe, like, maybe it was in the bathroom because we're right in the hallway. Where'd it go? I don't know what the hell. It glowed right here. Did it run away? Is that what that was? I'm also out of... Oh, no, I'm not. Okay. I mean, when it glows, it really glows. So we can't miss it. It just, it glowed right here, but I don't know what we're supposed to be looking for. Wait, can we cut the plant? I don't know why we would have to cut the plant. No. Okay, nowhere to apply. Oh! Turn around. Turn around. What the hell? What's happening to me? Dude, you're getting dusted. Oh, we're in the painting. Okay, everything here is painted. Yeah, we're in the painting. It's a painting of the painting inside the painting. I hope through the easel I can return... Oh, wait, no! That's it? Can we go back? I want to go back. I wasn't done exploring. I want to check this place out. Take me back to the evil painting. Okay, I cannot climb in the boat. Alright, before we explore... this is on Steam, yeah. It's a demo. It's free to play. Dublin Poppy, thank you for the 10-month resub. Cyborg, again, thank you for the Prime sub. And Sassy Cat, thank you for that rate of 8. I'm in the Soulstone. Tharad, how's it going? Nice boat. My father liked to go inside of paintings. My father was a boat captain. My father was a father. It kind of reminds me of... Remember the Land of the Lost? With Will Ferrell and John C. Reilly? I mean, I know it was like a remake of an older... At least a TV show. I don't know if there was like an older movie as well. But this reminds me of the one scene when they're kind of like in like a big open area like this. And there's just like random objects that... have like teleported there. Wait. Okay, there we go. How far can we go? It's the world between worlds. Dude, watch me go so far, that's gonna take us hours to get back. I just kept going. They didn't stop me. Is that a house? What's that over there? I must explore. You know, this reminds me of being outside the map in RDR 2. We're in Mexico. Oh, okay, that's good. I was hoping they wouldn't let me go too far for my own good. I'm gonna keep walking. It's up to the game to stop me. Okay, good. At least the game developers are responsible. Not irresponsible. I'm irresponsible. I would have ended up just walking on forever, just trying to explore every place that doesn't have anything to offer. We would just keep looking at nothing. And then I have to find my way back. Mario 64 going in paintings. Yeah, the giant crab. Yeah, and then they had all that crab meat. We're in Mexico, Arthur. My father had a babushka. Yeah, when Will Ferrell just gave up. Dude, that was a decent movie. Kind of weird, but it had Kenny Powers in it. I always forget his name. Don't tell me. Kenny Powers was played by... Don't tell me. Danny McBride. Kenny Powers, Austin Powers' little brother. Is that their relation? I didn't know that. Ditch? Where'd you go, Ditch? Arthur. Ditch? I'm in the painting, Arthur. I'm in the painting inside of Angelo Bronte's mansion. You gotta come get me, Arthur. I'm upstairs in the study. I'm in Tahiti.
Why would you go inside of a painting, Dutch?
It was a painting of Tahiti, Arthur. You know how I'm partial to Tahiti.
They had a painting of Tahiti?
Actually, it was just some mangoes.
They had a painting of some mangoes?
Okay, maybe they were just apples, but they look like mangoes.
Dutch, I don't think mangoes look like apples.
Would you just get me, Arthur? Would you just get me out of here? All right, let's go back.
And we're back.
All right. We're back. But I hope we weren't supposed to... Wait, was this shut before? Okay. Maybe I shut it. Oh, dude, look. It's gone. The rain must have washed it away. Maybe this is unlocked now? No. Okay. Now I have no idea what to do. Unless there was a key inside the painting that we were supposed to look at. Damn it, the food's gonna go bad. Well, what now? Yeah, it's like a little bracelet, but we can't pick that up. Can I go in this painting? How about this painting? Just go inside of all the paintings. I don't know what else to do. The ring is inside. Yep, we got that.
He had a painting of Tahiti, Ditch?
Surprised we haven't had another jump scare in a while. It's been a little too long. Alright, that guy's gone. Oh, there's a key inside! Okay, the key's inside the bird cage. Some sort of strange mechanism, I wonder how it works. I wonder if we need the shave. I never took this. No, I can't take it, okay. I don't know, maybe that was like some kind of weird... thing used to... Can I use the... No, we already used the scissors. Yeah, we can't use the scissors here. Matches, no. Alright. Trying to think. Birdcage with a weird mechanism. You mean a latch? You mean a door? Wait, it's got the scales of justice on the strange mechanism, also known as a hinge. What is this? Is there something that also has the scale of justice on it? Maybe another painting? Nothing there. No.
Похоже, что сегодня 12 марта 57-го.
What in the fuck? I don't want to have to go back inside the painting, but I feel like whatever we need, it's got to be in the painting, right? Like, why would we? You wouldn't just go inside the painting and then come back empty-handed. There's got to be something here. Let me look around the boat. There's got to be something. There's got to be some sort of importance to the. July 1st. 1956. My favorite pastime is looking at pictures and imagining myself inside this world. A world where I can be anyone. Traveler, ruler, brave pirate. I love to write stories about how I discover new lands or go in search of treasure on a huge ship. When I grow up, I will definitely work in a museum like my dad. Like my father. Can we climb up? There's got to be a way to get up here. Climb the tree. Climb the stump. Like, maybe there's something inside. Hey, let me check the controls. Is there anything that tells us... get, put lamp away, take action, maybe try that. Like, I don't see a rope or a ladder. My father. Angel Gaming, thank you for the 2-month resub. Baby Cakes, thank you again for the 19 bits. Matt Dill. Matt Dill, thank you for the 21 months. Crazy Ways, thank you again for the 4 months. Also, Sav Chib, thank you for the 10 bits. Wait, here, this is something. There's something ahead of the tree. Okay, like a little tire swing. All right. North, 70 degrees west. All right, that doesn't tell me shit. We don't have a compass. We don't have anything. We don't have a map. Nothing. It's like, okay, cool. Which way's north? Oh, there's a chest. Might as well be a pinata. Alright. What do we got in here? We got... little bird. Okay. My father gave it to me when I was very young. It's nice he kept it. Okay. Little bird for the bird birdcage. Is there anything else? That's it? You don't want to take any of that other stuff? You don't want any health tonics or a stamina potion? Nothing? You're good? No chug jugs? All right. Sandstorm's coming in. Follow the North Star. It's actually just the boat, not a North Star. Just the light on the boat. Follow the light. I'm assuming that's all we need. Because it said about the weird contraption on the bird cage. The chest gave us a bird. So we go back, we use the bird somehow to open the cage. All right, hopping back inside the painting. It's been a while. It's been a while since we had a jump scare, so I am... Oh!
Кто ты? Что тебе нужно?
I can't move. All right. Ah! Wait, what? No, no, no! The key! The bird! The cage! No! No! Ow! Damn it! It was actually starting to get good there. That's the demo. Version 1.1. The key! The bird! The cage! Not the cage. Well, that's it for now. The Renovator Origins. I wonder if that was the guy, the way he looked, he kind of looked like the guy that was out on the street. We couldn't really see the guy on the street because of like the rain and everything through the window, but he was kind of weird, you know, when he would run away. Similar build. I don't know what the hell that was. But it's got potential. I'll definitely play the full version when it comes out. This is way better than I expected. I wasn't sure. Looking at the screenshots, I was worried that it was going to be something like Martha is Dead. It's like, oh yeah, it's a horror game. Then you play it, it's like, this is not a horror game. I was worried that it was going to be... Man, we didn't even get to go inside the... We didn't get the key out of the bird cage. Like, you would think that we could at least get to the door that's locked. That's nice that you liked it. Liana, how are you doing? Big country boy. Thank you for the 28 month fat fucking resub. That's awesome. Thank you so much. Also, Angel Guide, thank you for the 1,000 bits. Baby Cakes with another 8 bits. And then Angel Gaming again. Did I say Angel? Oh, wait, hold on. We have, it's fucking me up. We have Angel Guide and Angel Gaming. I'm like, did I read that wrong? Angel Guide, thank you for the 1,000 bits. Angel Gaming, thank you for the gifted sub going out to Emilex. So many angels. You're my guardian angels. You're my guardian angels. Alan, you gotta change your name to Angel Carlson. Yeah, this is actually not bad. I feel like the demo could have been longer. Angel bug. Aww. Yeah, we could do some more. But yeah. Yeah. I'll definitely play the full version when that comes out. So there you go. The Renovator Origins. The Renovator Origins. Short and sweet. You know, maybe it's a good thing. Maybe it's a good thing they cut it off when they did, because it just makes you want more. Where if they would have let us into that door, maybe wouldn't be as, like, hyped to play the full version. I'm hoping it's more than just that. Dude. Imagine that the full version comes out, and the only difference between the demo and the full version is we get to unlock the birdcage and then get the key to unlock the door, and then the game ends officially right there. Like, thanks for playing the full game. Who is the renovator? We are. We're the renovator. I think that's why we're in the house. Yeah, we got something to look forward to. There's a renovator game. Oh, yeah, I love Chilla's art. Yeah. Because you might like them. Oh, yeah, I love them. And what sucks is the last game I played by them was the karaoke. Loved it. But my OBS had updated recently, and I didn't realize that my audio was, like, popping. So every time I talked, the microphone popped. And it wasn't, like, a little subtle, like, faint, like, noise in the background. It was almost like I was, like, snapping my fingers every time I would, like, start talking. Like, it was loud as shit. And, like, the whole audio was ruined. And I couldn't use it as, you know, as a video. Because I fucking love that game. And that's our most recent one. We've also played, I think, The Bathhouse was Chilla Art. Closing Shift was Chilla Art. They have a whole bunch of solid horror games. Don't blame the sound guy. Kevin James? When does the full version come out? I'm glad you asked. I don't know. Hold on. It says, okay, write this down. It says, coming soon. Coming soon. Okay. The renovator's assistant. Assistant to the mortuary. Mortuarian. Can you spell soon? Oh, play the original? Possibly. My father was a prequel. Dude, you ever notice how many fucking games there are? Pardon my French. There are so many games. Like, if you just go to Steam or Epic, just scroll through all the games. Like, weekly, I feel like 10 to 20 games come out every single week. My daddy. My father is a video game. My father is a gaming PC. Renovator came out in 2019. All right. Well, that was my only plan for tonight. Yeah, that's what I was thinking, the rod. Hang on, though. I have a couple. Wait, waiting for the bathroom. We played that. At the wrong house. I'm sorry, at the wrong place. We never played that. I do have a couple other horror games, like short horror games that we've never played before. Here's one called Under. One called Bloody Woman. Bloody Woman looks like a puppet combo Chilla Art type game. Project 2001. I don't know what this is. August Night. Oh, someone told me to check out this game. August Night. You guys want to check out Bloody Woman? Play Granny. My father was subscribed to SWOL. Well, that woke me up. Use headphones for a better experience. Use headphones so we can rupture your eardrums. That's right. Go ahead, put them on. Play alone in a dark room. I was... Dude, these games have like the best intros. They put all their money in the theme song. What was that game? Rewind or Die had some awesome chase music. There was a couple times where we were getting chased and the music kicked in. '80s school party vibes. Or, '80s montage vibes. You just got called out by the school bully, and now you got a train to fight him after school. Friday afternoon. You got 1 week to give it everything you got. To learn karate. At 3 o'clock high. What's up, Narniak? It's a little breakdown for you. I have the same knife. Oh, and blood. Okay, that's it. I don't know how long this is gonna be, but it could go either way, man. A game like this could be 10 minutes, could be 45. I wouldn't say it's more than an hour. And hey, there's no way for me to turn off the VHS filter. Not in this game. All right. So this game is called Bloody Woman. Bloody Woman. Bloody Woman. It's called Bloody Woman. All right, here we go. Are you really sure? You know, I clicked the download. I installed the download. I opened the game. I got this far, but you know what? Now that you mention it, I don't think I'm sure. Yeah. All right. I don't know what I was thinking. It's amazing I got this far, and I wasn't even sure I wanted to play this. Are you really sure? You come back. Are you really, really sure? 616 Games presents a game by 616 Games. Oh. Oh, it's like that. Oh. That's a lot of people. Here I'm thinking it's gonna be like a 10-minute game. They got longer credits than a Marvel movie. The one name just said Jay. Yeah, thanks, Jay. Dude, anybody named Jay could tell their friends, hey, go ahead and play that game, Bloody Woman. I think you'll recognize a name in those credits. Oh my God, Jay, is that you?
Yep.
That was me. What'd you do? A little bit of this, a little bit of that. You know, gaming stuff, gaming developer stuff. Oh, wait, can we? Okay. First night of work, and I'm already going to be late. Well, I don't know which way work is. Wait, hold on. Well, it's definitely not that way. All right. And still not that way. All right, here we go. I did like a 360. Well, this is nice. I'm going to turn the volume back up. I think the music in the intro is just extremely loud. Shit, who the fuck invented the job? Yeah, who was the first person to invent a job? What kind of question is that? Very restricted. We cannot cross the street. And I'm just going to check out. Okay, blocked there. Any killers in the dumpster? There are flies. Usually signifies some sort of a dead body. Possibly a dead body in the dumpster. Alright, I am going to do one thing though. Oh, there are camera filters! Oh! Oh, no, no, no. PS2? Oh! Oh, yeah, I like that. Horror? Ooh, even better. I think I'm gonna rock the horror filter and then 1995... Wait, where was the other one? Is this the one that we were looking at? I thought the one we had on was more. Either way, we'll go horror filter. All right. And I just want to turn the sensitivity down. It's only on a 2. Okay, now it's a 1. All right, manageable. Is that a red box? Okay, open 24. Is this where we work, or are we just getting some laundry done? You're late. Good evening, you must be the new employee. Arrived late. That's it. Oh. Good evening. Sorry for the delay. I missed the bus and I had to walk. Steven, I'm late for an appointment. I don't have time to explain your work. Okay, no problem. I just need to take care of the laundry and take care of customers who need help, right? Exactly. I left a paper with some tasks for you. Be careful. The night shift is sinister.
Sinister? What do you mean by this?
Don't you know the story of the Bloody Woman?
Bloody Woman? No, I don't know anything about that.
10 years ago, on a night just like tonight, a woman worked here on the early morning shift, but a machine shorted out and the laundry room caught fire. She was trapped inside. She had 90% of her body burned, but she was still rescued, alive. After a few months in the hospital, she disappeared. Her appearance was terrible. She was completely disfigured. The laundromat was rebuilt 2 years ago. Since then, it torments and kills everyone who works the late night shift.
My God, is this real? What the fuck, man? I'll be on the late night shift.
Relax, man. It's just a legend. I gotta go now. See you later. Well, see you later.
He didn't have time to explain our job, but he had time to scare the shit out of us before leaving us alone. Fantastic guy. Real stand-up guy. I guess I'll... Well, you know what? We gotta read our tasks first. Okay, cue to read. Newbie to-do list. Clean the floor. Fold the washed clothes and put them on the shelf. Take out the trash. All right, clean the floor. Fold the washed clothes. Put them on the shelf. Take out the trash. All right. Oh, yeah. Right. Can I do them in any order? I guess we have to do them in order. All right, clean the floor. It's not cleaning. Hold on. There we go. I mean, I'm not here to brag, but I feel like my sound effects were a little bit more accurate. And then here. Did the other employee just piss all over the floor? What is this? Hey, by the way, before I took off, I gave you something to do. Yeah, the floors were looking pretty clean, as you know, this is a laundromat, so not a lot goes on here. So I went ahead and just pissed all over the floors for you, so you'd have something to do. You can thank me later. Also, I love how we're using a broom to mop up the floor. Valkyrie, thank you for that raid of 4. Reminds you of the convenience store? Yeah, or any job. Yeah, any job that we've ever worked in a horror game, pretty much the same premise. We're always working the night shift, and the employee before us always sets us up for some crazy shit. And they never do... They always leave us with all the work. You know, you would think that the owner of the building would want all the, like, trash and everything taken out in the night shift, like the second shift, so that you're not going outside, you know, overnight. And then your job is to take out the trash at the end of your shift, which would be like 7 in the morning, like when the sun's up. Yeah, that's how, like, when I worked third shift, I used to be a third shift manager at McDonald's back in, like, 2004, 2005. I wasn't even born yet, Swole. We were supposed to leave the doors and everything locked. You know, we didn't take the trash out until, like, you know, when the next shift came in. Heard of Ice Cream? It's kind of gooey horror game, but you might like it. Wait, Ice Cream is a horror game? Valkyrie, thank you again for that raid. I remember the last one you played like this, that you shot 100 times and he ended up living in... Oh, yes, that was the... What was that? Not the VHS store. It was the one we were at the gas station. What the hell was that called? Purdue, what was that called? Ice Scream. Got it. What was that game called? The Night Shift. Midnight Shift. Yeah. Midnight Shift. All right. I think we got all of the stains on the floor. All the mystery stains. Nope. We got one more right here. Okay. It's clean. All right. You already put the broom back. Can I take the trash out yet? I want to get that out of the way because that requires us to go outside. Oh, wait, am I supposed to clock in? Oh, it doesn't work. Okay. Not thirsty right now. Hold E to rob cash register and take off early. All right, fold. Whoa,
Who turned on the washing machine? Oh, right. The bloody woman is here. Let me just double check this. Fold the wash clothes and put them on the shelf. I don't know what they mean by on the shelf. Okay. Quit playing with my laundry machines. Yeah, turn that off. I don't see. Fold. Maybe the one's back here. Oh, someone's here. We have a customer. What's up, Z? What is that? Wilson. Good night. I've never seen you around here.
Good evening, sir. This is my first day here. How can I help you?
I just came to pick up my clothes that I left here in the morning. I just came here to pick up my clothes that I left here in the morning. Aren't you afraid to work here at night?
Why would I be afraid? I'm just working.
Don't you know about the legend of the bloody woman? I would never agree to work here at night. Oh, but you'll come here at night. You know, you'll shop here. You'll use the business at night. You won't work here, but yet it's people like you that force people like me to actually be here. I have to be here because of people like you.
Yes, I already know about the legend. I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid. It's just a legend to scare children.
And laundromat employees.
It's not just a legend. I've always been a customer of this laundry. I knew the woman who had the accident. Her name was Mary.
Oh, Bloody Mary. Oh, fantastic. Great.
She was a very good person.
Oh, well then that's good.
After the fire and the burns, she became someone else. I visited her in the hospital twice, then she disappeared. Now they say she kills everyone who works here on the late shift.
I love how this woman kills everyone who works in the late shift. I assume we live in the area, yet we've never heard anything about people being murdered at the laundromat every single night because they have to get new employees. Like, we've never heard about any of that. She kills everyone, is what this guy says. Everyone who's ever worked the night shift since the fire, dead. And us, you know, the new employee, has never heard about that when looking into the job. They're like watching news reports. And another employee was murdered at the laundromat. Oh, maybe there's a job opening. I think I'll apply. That's how she got the job, or he. I don't know why I'm picturing. Did they say if it's a guy or girl that we're playing as? I don't think they ever, I don't think they specified.
I'm sorry, sir, but I'm not afraid. I'll get your clothes.
You are very beautiful. If you need anything, just call me. You have my number on the client list.
Thanks. I'll get your clothes.
Yeah, I was just doing a generic nerd voice. And for some reason, they must have... Maybe the other guy acknowledged us as a girl. Somehow I knew that because he just acknowledged it too. I'm playing as SWOL. Okay. Job description. Must be okay with being murdered. It's a temp job. Why is it temporary? Oh, because you're going to die the first night. Yeah, we have a high turnover rate. Oh, yeah. Get his clothes. Is this his clothes? No. Here we go. Wilson, got you right here. Here you go. Hey, don't leave me! Don't leave me! Okay, that was done. I still don't know how we fold, like, none of this. None of this. Oh, here we go. All right, fold clothes. You know, this job ain't so bad. I mean, aside from being murdered, It's a pretty easy gig. Here we go. Fold clothes successfully. And now we can take out the trash. Or not. We put them on the...
Oh, whoa, whoa!
I'm pretty sure that was a bloody woman. I better take this. I don't need it right now? Okay. Definitely saw a bloody woman. That's me. Now, oh, we still can't take out the trash? Okay, good, because I didn't want to. You know what? I didn't want to. And let's lock the door. No! Alright, fire extinguisher? Is she going to burn this place down? They wouldn't give us this option unless we could use it later on. So, fire extinguisher will probably come into play. Well, maybe just knock her out with it. I'm not sure. Okay, we did all that and take out the trash. Well, it won't let me pick up the trash. Maybe it doesn't want us to yet. So what now? Oh, dude. You know what? I'm tired of being a pussy. Let's get this over with. I don't like this job anyway. Where you at, Bloody Mary? Show yourself, Bloody Mary! I said it twice. Bloody Mary. Oh! Whoa! Whoa! God damn it! Okay, this one has skin. Yeah. Her skin has not been burned. Oh, hey, Martha. Hello, my name is Martha. I've come to pick up my clothes. It's already paid for. Good evening, ma'am. Generic nerd voice applies to male and female. Have you been a customer of this laundry for a long time? Yes, I've been washing clothes here for a few years. Do you know anything about the fire that happened here? That was a long time ago. That was at least 4 months ago. But I heard about it. It was all over the newspapers. Do you know anything about the woman who worked here? I don't know her, but I heard that she has burns all over her body. You don't believe in the legend of the bloody woman, right? No, I know it's just a legend, thank you. Can you take my clothes? Okay, sorry to bother you. I'll go get your clothes. Martha. Got it. Such an assortment of colors, Martha. There you go. Just carry your laundry away like a pizza box. Well, if a pizza box, a stack of pizza boxes were worn as a boxing glove. Pizza boxing gloves. Pizza boxing gloves. Can I take the trash out yet? Yes. All right. We can take the trash out. So be prepared. Let me just double check. Is there any bloody burned women walking around? No. All right. So here we go. Mikey, thank you for the 14 months. Appreciate that. Girly Pop, thank you for the follow. Baby Cakes, thank you for the 10 bits. Beetlejuice. If she's a real person, just cap her. I don't think I have a gun. I don't know if they keep a gun in the store.
All right, let's grab the trash. We take multiple bags. Nope, one bag at a time. And can I go out the back door? Is it locked? Can we unlock it? No. Got these flies in my face. Oh God. Is that blood? What the fuck is going on here? What do you think is going on here? Okay, good. No jump scare in the dumpster. Ah, what the fuck was that? Sorry. It was just a fly. But it looked like smoke or something was coming out of the dumpster until it, you know, I realized it was a fly. I'm not scared. What was that? What was that? That was a fly, Swole. Okay. I feel like when the lights flicker, it means she's close by. Because that happened the last time. The last time the lights flickered, that's when we saw her walk past the window. Alright. Still can't grab the flashlight. Oh God. Alright. Bag number two. Makes you wonder whose blood that is. Is that her blood? Like, is she dripping blood from her burned body? Or did she murder Martha or Wilson? Okay, that's two. So far, so good. Safe and sound. What the fuck? Hey, it's probably just a raccoon. All right, last bag. Let's just make it quick. I'm gonna leave that door open so we can just run back into the store. Okay, ah, shit. There is something in here, right? Okay, no. Nothing. I was really expecting a jump scare out of the dumpster. Again, missed opportunity. Okay. So let's head back to the store. I wish we could lock this door. Alright. I wish we could take the flashlight just in case. This stupid radio is always turning themselves on. Shit, is anyone there? Is that the same washing machine that was going off earlier? Yeah, it's the same one. Here comes a customer. I can't tell if it's Bloody Mary. No, it's Walter Hartwell White. Oh, never mind. Steve, my bad. Good evening, young man. Did you start working here today? Wait, okay, so Wilson said that we're beautiful. And now this dude's saying young man, so I guess Wilson, you know. I don't know. good evening, young man. Did you start working here today? Good evening, sir. Yes, this is my first day here. How can I help you? I came to get my clothes. My God, they were so dirty. Excuse me, sir. Can I ask you something? Do you have any meth? Of course, boy. I love talking in laundromats at night. What the fuck am I reading? I'm reading words that don't even exist. You seem to be a longtime customer of this laundry. I think the legend of the Bloody Woman is real, or am I going crazy?
Bloody Woman? Yes, I always knew it was real. I've seen her wandering around here at night. I tried to time my visits between her coming and going.
What do I do? She wants to kill me.
How do you know? She might not want to kill you.
You haven't talked to her yet. You don't know her motives.
I didn't do anything to her.
What do I do? She wants to kill me. I didn't do anything to her.
There's no escape, boy.
Wait.
There's no escape, boy. She was just working. What happened was horrible. Please, just get my clothes. I need to go.
Well, hold on, hold on. Now, it says me, but I think that's him talking. So, let me redo that.
There's no escape, boy. She was just working. What happened was horrible. Please get my clothes. I need to go.
Okay. Walter White. Walter White.
And stay out.
Well, at least they shut the door behind him. Oh, perfect. All right, we got a storm rolling in. All the trash is done. Clothes are put away. Like, I'm good. Okay, can we grab the flashlight? No, we can't grab the flashlight yet. Can I grab it now? How about now? There we go. Third time's a charm. Music intensifies. All right. Door opened. What? Wait, well, hold on. Okay, so the door opened. Someone's in here. I see flies. Yeah, there's flies right here flying around. I wonder if that's because she's in here. I don't see her, though. Should I go outside? Like, if she's in here, then the safest place to be would be outside. Let's go outside. Like, famous last words. There we go. All right. Yeah, much safer out here. Next to the dark woods. Oh, all the power is out. Okay. No street lights or anything. Oh, I guess I'll go home. What do you want from me? Leave me alone. Am I supposed to be in the store? She's talking to me. Do you just want your job back? You can have it. If that's all this is about. All right. Let me shut that again. All right. Is that her again? I don't know if she... Did she leave? Wait, footsteps? I'm just backing up into a corner. I definitely heard footsteps in the back. Or maybe she was banging on the door. Should I go back there and make sure it's still shut? Yeah, I can see from here. It's still shut. Can I get a drink? I'm kind of thirsty. No, you are thirsty. All right, so what now? I'm not going outside. I'm just going to hang out here till something happens. Right here. This is where I'm going to stay. Wait until morning. Mist of Death, how's it going? Where's the secret entrance to the lab? Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, we are working in a laundromat. Like, in a laundry place. Not as big of an operation as Gus Fring's place. Oh, man. I went to the grocery store before I streamed. I got some honey mustard and onion pretzels. Oh, I can't wait. They're calling my name. I got laundry to do. Yeah, how do we get down to the meth lab? Dude, they're so good. Honey mustard and onion. HMOs. I also got regular pretzel sticks and some hummus. That's the go-to right there. I don't always have hummus. But when I do, I dip my pretzels in it. You want this game, but you're scared. Well, let's go on this journey together then.
Stay behind me. I'll protect you. Until I'm dead, then you're on your own. Los pollos hermanos.
Oh, there she is. Okay. I mean, if she wanted to murder me, she was already in the store. And then she left. And then she left. Like, you would think that if she was going to do something, she would have done it when she was already in here. Like, why taunt me at the window when you were already in the place? You could have killed me then. All right. Can you stay here with me? Greg, I hate being in the dark, even more so when it's raining.
Good evening, sir. Please need to help me.
I'm so scared I don't even know how to talk. Relax, boy. You're very scared. What happened?
The bloody woman, she's back. And she's going to try and kill me. Shit. What do I do?
The bloody woman? Ha ha, this is just a legend, boy. Rest assured.
I'm not kidding. I saw her, I swear.
I'm sorry. I'm really late for an appointment. Could you take my clothes? Dude, it's like 1 a.m. Where are you going? I'm running late for a booty call. Can you please get my clothes?
Okay, thanks for your help, sir.
All right, what was his name? I didn't even catch his name. Greg. All right, Greg, there you go. Got your umbrella. Oh, nice. Ooh. Grego, thank you for the rate of 2. Appreciate that. And energy drink. Thank you for the 500 bits.
My father had a booty call. Hey, get yourself a dick appointment.
Torment first, then that, yeah, this is Pennywise. Pennywise mentality.
Zed's dead, baby. Zed's dead.
You're like my online dad. It's weird to like think about that. Because I started this whole journey when I was 33. I'm still in my 30s. But I feel like in the last 6 years, I went from being like, oh yeah, young swole, you don't look a day past 28. To like, hey, you remind me of my dad. My first reaction when I got my Switch. What do you mean? It wasn't like a present. There's not much reaction when you go to the store and you just buy it. Oh my God, there's a Switch in my hands. Oh yeah, I bought it. It's not like someone handed me like a box with wrapping paper and I opened it up and was like, holy shit, I can play Zelda. Switchblade. Yeah, we're going to start tomorrow. We're going to start Breath of the Kingdom. I'm sorry. Tears of the Wild. Who knows? If I want to wake up, I want to go to the gym. I'm probably going to start streaming somewhere between noon and 1. And then If my controller arrives before that, I get my mail delivered to my parents' house, so just gotta drive over there, pick up my controller. Either way, one stream with a regular controller, with the Joy-Cons, shouldn't be a problem. Open mouth YouTube thumbnail reaction in Walmart. Yeah, in Walmart. You gotta angle it. Pro controller? I got it on Amazon. They had a bunch of different ones. It's not like an official Nintendo one. Let me see, Ditch. I don't know. It's got over 6,000 reviews with a 4.6 rating, so I figured it would be good. That right there. That bad boy right there. All right. Let's get back into this. You like the stream? Good to hear. So that should work though, right? I'm worried that because I bought that little thing to get my Xbox controller working, it won't. I'm worried that what if there's something wrong with the Switch and that's why it won't connect. But I gave up trying to get that to work. So I just said, fuck it, and just bought an actual controller that belongs to the Switch. Mary, are you here?
Mary, come out and play, yay. Mary, stop rummaging through our dumpster, Mary. Someone's got to clean that up. It's probably me. It's not funny, Mary.
That's it, Mary. It's time for the ultimate showdown. Whose blood is this? Oh! Is that Greg? Wait, no. Who is that? My God, it's the guy who works here. Okay. We don't even know his name. And I missed what it said. Son of a bitch. I was all caught up on... Are you okay? Do you need a doctor? Man who works here. Man who used to work here. Do you need help? One moan for yes, two moans for no. Okay. Well, that's what he gets. Yeah, it's his own fault. Talking about how the person who works overnight's the ones that always gets killed. And Mary was like, yeah, I'll fucking show you. You wanna call out my pattern? You wanna predict my next attack? Yeah? Well, fuck you. I'm gonna kill you. Why is he still here? He went home, didn't he? Did she like follow him, kill him, and then bring him back? But she's been here messing with us. Look, I'm done asking questions. It is what it is. That's not a red box, by the way. It's definitely a... Definitely like a drink machine. Okay, let's go back inside. Let's go back inside where it's safe. Okay. Okay. All is good. All is good. Power's back on. No sign of Bloody Mary. There's a scratch at the door. Can I open this? No. Should we go outside and look? There's definitely a scratching sound at the door. But I was just out there. I didn't see anything. Wait, maybe it stopped. Okay. All right, we have another customer coming in here. All right. It's Patrick Stewart as Slenderman. Unknown.
Good night, boy.
We'll give him like a Kratos voice.
Good night, boy. It's a beautiful night.
Sir, I need help. There's a dead guy. There's a dead guy back there. Someone is trying to kill me.
I know. Poor Steven. Just a working man. Just like you, Mary won't stop. She wants blood.
Are you kidding me? You know the bloody woman?
Why, yes. She's my ex-wife. Yes, I know her. She is not part of the world of the dead. But your death is guaranteed, boy. She won't let you go.
Shit! Who the hell are you?
I'm nobody. I'm just working, just like you.
So you don't want anything? No laundry? You want some detergent? Maybe some bleach? As we see her, like, run out and kill him.
Boy.
See you later, Patrick Stewart, Slender Man. It was nice knowing you.
You gotta help me.
You crazy old man. So now what? Just hang out? You know, that clock has not changed at all since we started. Man, this shift is taking forever. Still not thirsty. Alright, let's go back outside. Because death. Alright, he's still dead. Nothing at the back door. I wonder if this game has multiple endings. Oh. Were those always there? I guess so. I just wasn't paying attention.
Oh, jeez.
Boy.
All right. So I guess we just... Oh, let me shut this. It doesn't guarantee that we won't get murdered. It'll just guarantee that we won't get murdered as fast. Put one obstacle between us and Bloody Mary. Please stop wasting the water. Oh, there she goes. There she goes. Got you now, bitch. I got you now. I heard thumping. Okay, definitely not in the dumpster. Definitely not out back. Definitely not doing laundry in the store. Unless she's in the back room. Yo, yeah, dude. There, we got a blood trail. Got a blood trail. All right. Little peaks, little peaks, baby steps and little peaks. Okay. She's not here. Oh! Oh! Bloody woman got us. Bloody woman got us. Good. That was good. I'm so curious as to, like, you know, why could we even hover over certain items if we were never going to use them? We never got to use the fire extinguisher. We never got to use the water cooler. I mean, it's not a big deal. I thought that was a very, very well-paced indie horror game. Like, very small. I mean, I know indie horror games come in all shapes and sizes, but that was a nice little indie horror game. Solid. Solid. I honestly thought it was going to be a little longer than that. But overall, good. Good premise. Standard premise. It seems like they're just covering all jobs at this point. All right, we need a horror game. What are we going to do? How do we set this up? All right, well, we're working at a convenience store. Nope, already been done. Okay. All right, we're working at a video rental shop. Nope, already been done. Okay. Laundromat. Been done, but it's been a while. Okay, let's go with that one. Remember Blood Wash? Yeah, so there you go. Bloody woman. No one survives. I liked it. That was a good one. It was good. Jasmine Space, thank you for the $3 donation. The ending music took all the scary moment away. I don't know. I liked it. Sir Quinn, thank you for the 10 months. Baby Cakes, appreciate the 3-month resub. Shit, my window's open. I forgot. Oh man, just joined in on the live. Oh, you missed a really good game. Bloody Woman.
Bloody Woman. Walking down the street. Bloody Woman.
Am I playing Outlast? Tonight? Probably not. Yeah, probably not at this point. Maybe play one more short horror game. And then I want to get some sleep because I'm gonna stream long tomorrow. You should play Depart. Depart, okay. We start singing at the same time.
Bloody woman, turn me into meat, bloody woman.
Night of the customers? Night of the consumers? No. No. Dimeburn? Yeah, we played Madison. Google said there's more endings to that game. I don't even know what, like, I didn't see any option. Because, you know, sometimes it's like, okay, if we didn't do this, then maybe this would happen. That was a pretty linear game. Yeah, because even when there was noises, we went and checked out back. Like, I faced Bloody Mary head on. What's up, Amish Ace? Bloody woman coming down the street. Bloody woman. So I would like to meet Bloody woman. She definitely had TB, Bloody woman. All right, that's Bloody Woman.
Bloody Woman. Bloody Woman.
All right. Now we have Under. Not Under Depths of Fear. This is a different one. Just Under. Project. I don't know. Oh, August Night. Let's do this one. Let's do August Night. You know, it's funny. I never even changed my Twitch info. We're still playing Renovator Origins. August night. August night. I'm really worried that I'm gonna push it a little too far. Like right now, I think we're in good shape. I could end right now, but I think we can squeeze in one more. And my fear is that squeezing in one more will end up turning into like a 4-hour playthrough. Like I picked the wrong game.
Kinda like to meet Bloody Woman.
Zach, that's good to hear. Thanks again for that raid.
Push it to the limit.
In my Stuff of the Night video, I've had a couple people comment on my flamingo pelican comment. Remember how she had a flamingo by her desk? It was like a neon, little neon light. And I was like, I think I said, look at the pelican, Manny. Or just look at the pelican. And people were like, Swole, that's a flamingo. Or someone else commented, when you said, look at the pelican, I was like, no, that's a flamingo. That was a comment. And I'm like, no one's seen Scarface. I know it's a flamingo. I always say that. Anytime we see a flamingo in a game, I always say, look at the pelican, Manny. Look at the pelican. Yeah, the Pearson denim jacket. Pearson. Dude, I bet you we'll hit 90,000 this week. Hopefully. We're so close. We are less than 400. I think we're at like 350 away from 90,000. I might stream on TikTok. Because we'll be playing Zelda. The only thing I have to worry about is spoilers. That's the only thing that sucks about TikTok. TikTok has no respect. TikTok has no respect. No respect. I feel like over here on Twitch, majority of people, yes, there's a few bad apples, not you guys. I'm just talking about random people that join the stream. There's a few bad apples that just want to watch the world burn. But I feel like Twitch is a space for gamers where we kind of, you know, you respect the spoil. You respect the game. You respect not to spoil the game. But TikTok says, hey, check this out. Arthur dies in the end. Okay. What does Roman Reigns say? What the hell? He doesn't say respect me. What the hell does Roman Reigns say? Zero respect. Then the stats change. Arthur dies 5 years later. Spoil God of War Ragnarok. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. Like, that's my biggest concern.
Acknowledge me.
That's it.
Acknowledge me.
Yeah. So, yeah, TikTok definitely helps the channel grow when I dual stream. And I haven't been uploading clips there lately. So the stream, what I found out is that if you upload clips and your clips do well, and then you try to stream, your stream doesn't get pushed out. But if you don't upload clips that much, then you try to stream, then your stream gets pushed out.
The internet is dark and full of spoilers. Here, take this.
Acknowledge me too. Did I hear about Randy Orton? Oh no, what happened? Recently? Mod squad. Oh, I do have a mod squad for TikTok. But not everybody catches everything, you know? Like, I mean, I'm playing, but I'm always scanning the chat, like using my perifs. And there's always a chance I'll read something before it gets deleted. It's so welcoming here.
We'll see about that.
No, it's a very chill community. Dishpit Jake, did you change your name again? Did you change it back to Dishpit Jake? Or is this another account? You did, okay. Yeah, I will say, it is tough. Once you brand yourself something, it's very hard to change it. It's almost like in real life. Like, if your name is John, and then you just decide to call yourself Steve, like, good luck convincing your friends and family and everybody that's known you as one name to start calling you something else. They will always look at you as John, but if you want them to call you Steve, they will, but you'll always be John, like, no matter what. So, like, for me, I started off as True Swolger. That was my name on YouTube because I just used my gamer tag. And then everybody called me Swole. So one time I tried to rebrand here on Twitch because I was like, shit, I can, you know, I got a fresh start here on Twitch. You know, I'm not on YouTube anymore. So you see the Dr. Squatch soap commercials? There was a soap called Bay Rum. And I'm like, oh, dude, Bay Rum. That sounds like that's a cool name. I like the beach. I go on cruises. I don't drink, which is kind of funny, but Bay Rum sounds really cool. Like that has it's short, you know, it's got a nice like punch to it. Bay Rum. So then I changed my name to Bay Rum, and dude, it was fucking World War III. No one fucking liked it. I would enter chats and I would tell people that it was me, and they were like, oh my God, why? Why'd you change your name? I'm like, fuck, like that's the last thing I need. Like, I need a confidence boost because I'm already like having doubts about this fucking name. And then everybody's, you know, instantly hating it, which made me regret it. I had it for 4 hours maybe. And by that point, I fucking regretted it. And then I had to wait 60 days. So we had 60 days of Bayrum. 60 days? Did we really have it for that long? You can't change it, right? You have to wait 60 days. I can't believe I was Bayrum for 2 months. It doesn't even seem right. Because it's such a flicker of time. It doesn't seem like that much time went by. So I changed it. At that point, I changed it back to Swol. Like, it was True Swolger, but everybody called me Swol. So I changed it to Swol TV. So it was an easier transition since everybody called me Swol already for short. Like, to go from True Swolger to just Swol was a natural change. And then eventually when I hit partner, I dropped the TV part and I was able to get Swol from a dead channel. Another channel had Swol, but they weren't even active for like 10 years. So I wanted to drop the TV part and just go Swol. And here we are. Yeah, to get your name back, it's a total... Yeah, 60 days. Well, 6 months to get your name back, but I didn't get my name back. I changed my name. So, yeah, 60 days. Yeah, it was a nightmare. Changed my name a few years ago for gender reasons, and I can still agree with that. Old identities follow you everywhere. Gotcha. Yeah, it's just like that's who you are, you know? I mean, regardless of, like, you know, what you believe and how you feel, but like, you know, you're born in this world and like you're given a name and everybody knows you by that, and then you try to change it, but like that's you to everybody else. Glad you caught me streaming again. Nice. Change my name to Amaranth TV. And I got to get a hot tub. I'll just get like a 5-gallon bucket and just stand in it. Like, what the hell is this? Ah. Oh, your name's Walter Jr., but you go by Flynn? That makes sense. Why won't you fucking die? You need to change the emote to the new stuff? No, I still... Well, I've been drinking this, but, I mean... I thought something was on fire. I can see the reflection of my fan in my desk, and it looked like smoke out of the corner of my eye. Yeah, we ain't changing that emote. That emote's not dead yet. It's still relevant.
It's still relevant. It's still relevant. Autobots, roll out.
Do I miss coffee? I definitely miss the taste of coffee. I love coffee. I didn't like quit coffee. I just quit coffee while I was drinking this stuff because I wanted an honest review of it. I didn't want to be like, yeah, guys, this stuff works. And then like, but also being hopped up on like four cups of coffee. It's like, how can you tell us it works? You know, or you feel anything if you've been drinking coffee the whole time on top of it. So yeah, tomorrow will be 3 weeks. MGS5. I don't know what that is. MGS5. Does it work? Yeah. Yeah. In fact, like giving myself a break from coffee was probably also much needed because the caffeine from this is from green tea. It's not from like coffee beans or anything. So it's a different type. And with the people at Advanced GG, the guy I was talking to, explained that with the green tea, it has more of like a slow decline where coffee tends to crash. So if you drink coffee, usually it's like 2 or 3 hours later, you're fucking like, boom, like energy just drops off. And this, they explained it to me, and I definitely feel what they're saying, like now that I'm actually drinking it, because I'll start working at like 8 in the morning. I'll drink one of these while I'm working, and it's like 2 in the afternoon, and like I don't feel as energetic, but I don't feel that like, you know, 11 a.m. fuck, I got to go take a nap or my eyes are fucking killing me right now feeling. Like I feel like I can just keep working. Yeah, yeah. Well, I mean, I'm pretty good when it comes to like I quit drinking back in 2010. So I mean, overcoming that, it's easy to overcome other stuff. Like I consider this more of a supplement. Like I stopped drinking actual energy drinks, like no Monsters. I don't drink Red Bulls and shit like that. And I cut that off cold turkey. One day my buddy was like, "You know, I think I'm going to quit drinking energy drinks." I'm like, "Sounds good." And we just quit. I think he started drinking them again, but I just have that mentality where like I go so long not doing something that I don't want to break the streak. But yeah, I definitely love the taste. Like to me, coffee wasn't always about, oh, I need to drink this coffee to stay awake. Sometimes it was like, I need a snack, but I'm not hungry. I just want something. I just want some kind of flavor. And like coffee to me was just a snack sometimes. Bangs. I never had a bang. I used to drink like four Red Bull or four Monsters a day because it was like 2 for $5 at the gas station. So in the morning, I would stop and grab two. And then in the afternoon, I'd grab two more. You can have decaf. Well, I mean, that's like drinking non-alcoholic beer. I mean, if I'm going to drink it, I might as well get the energy too. Quit dipping. Dude, I've only tried chew twice in my life. The first time I was partying with friends up at Penn State and we like someone was dipping and they were like, "Hey, you want some?" I was like, "Sure, let me try this." So I tried it. And I remember like, I don't know if I spit it out or what, but I remember doing a beer bong. And like when I was done with the beer bong, it like backfed up the tube and like the tobacco that was in my mouth was like up the tube of the beer bong. I remember that. And then I got real fucking sick. Like the shit made me really dizzy. And I remember throwing up. And then fast forward 15 years later, my buddy, it was after the gym. We stopped at the gas station. We were just kind of hanging out like in the parking lot. And he's like, "Hey, you want some?" Because he just bought some chew. He gave me some. And I fucking puked. like 5 minutes later, I got real fucking dizzy and threw up. Yeah, I can't do it. Yeah. So good. It's an expensive habit. Good thing I can't stand it. I mean, if people do it, it's like, that's cool. That's your thing. I mean, physically, I can't do it. It makes me really dizzy and I puke. Biohaz, thank you for the Prime sub. Amish Ace, thank you again for the 9-month resub. Are you still here? Me and Amish Ace, I'm streaming I keep saying Breath of the Wild. I'm going to be streaming Tears of the Kingdom this week, but me and Amish Ace are planning on a stream Thursday night. We're going to be playing probably Demonologist Thursday night. So Thursday is going to be a long day. I'm going to stream during the day and then stream with him at nighttime. Biohaz, thank you for that Prime sub. Prime sub, bub. Sister is a 3-pack-a-day smoker. Her and her boyfriend spend more on cigs than their mortgage for their house. How much is a pack of cigarettes nowadays? How much is a pack of cigarettes? A pack of cigs to the layperson. $11? You and Devil James, my favorite Artie or Two streamers back in the day. Yeah, Dimeburn, I definitely know your name. You've definitely been around for a while. Depends, 11 to 15, call it 15. Three packs a day, that's 45. We'll call that $50 a day after tax. $50 a day. $1,500 a month? Holy fuck. $1,500 a month, right? It's like $50 times 30 days. And that's each. Each of them smokes 3 packs a day, right? Also, oh my God. So $3,000? $3,000 a month for a horrible habit. That sucks. What sucks is, like, you know, in the 80s and 90s, you know, people smoked. Well, I would say like the 70s and 80s. People smoked because back then it was like, it was cool. You know, it was the thing to do. And there wasn't enough studies to like really kind of show like the side effects of it. What's sad is when you see like kids nowadays starting to smoke. Like after, you know, the big thing that I learned about smoking is that, you know, people say it's a stress reliever. But what happens is that you start smoking just as out of habit or just as of like peer pressure and shit. And what happens is like when you don't smoke, your brain gets agitated because it craves that nicotine. So like, let's say you're stressed out about work and then you don't have a cigarette. So not only are you stressed about work, your brain is now stressed due to lack of nicotine. So when you smoke a cigarette, you're leaving only half the stress. You're still stressed about work, but it gives you a false sense of like, you know, stress relief. But really, it's only curing the stress that you caused yourself with the nicotine addiction. So now that we all know that, it's like, dude, there's literally no point in smoking whatsoever. But when you see like young kids like pick up the habit now, it's like, dude, what the fuck are you doing? Like, I get it when there's like, you know, people in their 50s and 60s still smoking, because it just, you know, my dad quit recently. He smoked his entire life and he quit. I think he was like 60 years old when he finally quit. So good for him. But it took a long time, a lot of years trying to quit and just never staying on it. Gym bros smoke around me? No. Well, I don't have a lot of friends, so yeah, no, none of my friends smoke. Once in a while, me and my best friend, like, he has a hot tub, and like when I go out there, we'll smoke a cigar in the hot tub. But again, it's the you know, same thing with the chew. I get dizzy as shit when I smoke cigarettes or smoke cigars, or the two times I've tried chew. Like, nicotine just makes me sick to my stomach. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's not as socially acceptable, but all the studies and shit behind it now, it's just sad when you see, like, I remember even in like the late 90s, early 2000s, there was like a public pool like in my town. And you would see, like, dude, 13, 14-year-olds smoking at the picnic tables, like, across the street at the park. It's like, what the fuck, man? Like, you're setting yourself up for a lifetime of wasted money. There's, like, no music in the background, no nothing. Yeah. Worst thing for patients to quit in the hospital is cigarettes. Worse than hard drugs. Helsing Queen, thank you for the 10 bits. I heard smoking increases your heart rate too, so it's actually not physically calming. Well, what I was saying is that, like, it's like your stress about work, or I keep saying work as an example, and then you smoke, but really it's only alleviating the craving for the cigarette, not the actual stress. So when you still have to deal with the same stress. You're actually causing yourself to be double stressed. So if you're stressed about something and you also smoke, you're also stressed about not having a cigarette, because you're actually creating more stress in your life by smoking. Pre-workout addiction is real. I wouldn't say I'm addicted to pre-workout. Yeah, no, I'm definitely not. In fact, once in a while, I'll get a pre-workout, but for the most part, I don't drink any like pre-workouts. The only supplement I really take is like a multivitamin, and I drink my protein shakes. Health class was SWOL. Gotta hop off. Well, I'm gonna do one more game here real quick. Did I? Yeah, I did. I was wondering if I set up the next game. Okay, so wait, is this the next game? It is, okay. I thought I was still in the last game. I didn't realize I switched games. Dude, Flintstone chewables are so good. Protein shakes. All right, this game is called August Night. I don't know if it's going to jump right into the game or if there's going to be a menu screen. In case there's not, August Night is the name of the game. The end. There's just like a jump scare in the window and that's it. I wonder if we're in the same apartment building. All right, we got the phone ringing. I can't move yet. Can I? There we go. Okay. All right, we don't have any yellow shades, so I don't think it was our apartment. Okay, give me 1 second to look around here. I got some cigarettes over here. 4 in the morning. Dude, I like how, like, watch when you zoom in. It's out of focus and then it goes into focus. I kind of like that. It's a unique look. You don't see that very often. Because it's like almost like disorienting. Like, oh, what is that? And then it like comes into focus. Can't open that. Alright. This is definitely PT vibes. Slight PT vibes. Actually, this looks like the house from, I think it was Father's Day. Alright. Hello? Should we move on, or am I waiting for someone to talk? Something's happening. But the voice is changing. Okay, we're gonna move on. Okay, we can't open that door. Nothing outside. Dude, I keep hearing something. Sounds like a rumbling sound, like something rolling down the hallway. Okay, this light was off. Right, hang on a second, someone's at the door. Yeah. Maintain pressing E. Wait, you have to press all of these? Well, unplug my controller. Dude, there we go. I barely caught that. I saw a shadowy figure. Oh, here we go. Oh, still out there. Okay. Still out there. I can't, like, stay looking. Still out there. Oh, it's their eyeball looking back at us. And they're gone. Okay. Oh, one more look. Okay. And they're gone. All right, something's on TV. Let me check this out real quick. Sounds of a crying woman. Lots of sound effects. Can we? Still four in the morning. Okay, that creature is not in our house yet. Let me just double check. Maybe he's still outside. No, he's not out there. It keeps like pulling me back in. I thought that sound was coming from the TV. Whatever's making that crying sound or that whimpering sound is coming from around the corner. Baby steps and tiny peaks. Okay, this door is now open. Oh, fuck no. Is she laughing or crying? Is there a light? Can we turn on a light? Yeah, the door shut behind us. Is that an alien? Should I pull the curtain back or what's it doing? Now it's a dinosaur. It turned into a T-Rex. Oh, shadow puppets. Okay. All right, the door unlocked. I'm backing up. All right. I'm surprised that didn't end in a jump scare. But at the same time, I'm glad it didn't because it was like, we already saw there was an image behind the curtain. It wouldn't be as, it wouldn't have been as good, like obviously looking at what's about to jump scare us. It's better if we don't know what's coming. Okay, nothing on TV. Dude, it's so dark in here. It's a lot of back and forth. All right, let me check the peephole again. All right, still nothing there. There isn't much to this game. Like, there's not a lot to interact with unless it tells you. You can't just, like, go up to a drawer and open a drawer or pick up an object. Only one time did it say we can interact with the peephole. Okay. Still nothing. Oh, wait, there's a handprint on the phone. Was that always there? I don't remember seeing that before, but you can only see it from like, you gotta catch the light in the right direction. Maybe it was always there. Alright, it looks like the light in the bathroom is back on. Oh, here we go. Is that, oh, it's a TV remote. Okay, we got that.
cockroaches. Got some cockroaches. Oh, lots of cockroaches. Did they do that? Oh my God. Ugh. There was a movie in the 90s called Joe's Apartment. It was about a guy that had a bunch of cockroaches, but the cockroaches, I think, like, worked with him to, like, save his job or something. I forget what the plot was. I just remember there was tons of cockroaches in his apartment. Wow. Dude, the ceiling looks like Swiss cheese. Oh my God. All right, we have the TV remote. Oh, okay, the hallway's gone. So the ghost is remodeling our apartment. Oh! Can we use the remote to change the channel? He's like, can you help me? I'm not trying to scare you. What the fuck? I was gonna say, I'm not trying to scare you. I'm just stuck. Can you help pull me out? Because the way he was like wiggling and shit. Yeah, I'm not a ghost. I'm not a ghost. I'm a TV repairman. I'm stuck in here. Can you pull me out? Wow, that was a cool ending. Help, stepbrother. I'm stuck in the TV. Wow, that was interesting. I had so much fun creating the game, and I really hope you had fun playing it. I will be so thankful if you shared the game with your friends and posted screenshots or videos of it on social media. A great response will make me motivated to create better and bigger games. I didn't see the rest of it. I don't know why. I started with the last paragraph. See you later in the next game. Okay. That's it. Some sound effects I used, and it just closes out. Wow. Dude, I like that ending. I kind of wish more games would like corrupt like that. You know, I think that would be a fair ending. Not every game, but like that one kind of dealt with like electric devices and the TV glitching out, and then all of a sudden, boom, like the actual game glitches out too. It kind of makes it immersive. I've played a few games where it's done that at the end. And if done right, I think that's a pretty valid ending. Especially, you know what? It'd be cool if there was like a real ending. Let's say it's a bigger horror game. The game does have like its final conclusion, and then there's like a post credit scare, or like an epilogue, like mini section that ends with something like that. Ditch, I'm stuck in the TV, ditch.